We've been getting loads of requests to show you guys how to paint models as if they're stamping through the dusts of Mars. So in this video, we're going to show you exactly how to do that using this awesome Ultramarines Redemptor Dreadnought. By the time we're finished, we're going to have the base completely painted and it will look like it's got Martian dust all over its legs too. Now, the first thing you'll notice is we've actually finished the model entirely. You'll see the Ultramarines Dreadnought has already got its transfers, all highlights and other things done to it first. The reason we do that is because weathering is always the last thing that goes onto a model, just like machines in real life. Now, the first stage is we're going to be using Doomball Brown in a couple of ways. The first way we're going to use Doomball Brown is by painting all over the top of the base. Grab yourself your large base brush for this. Let's grab a bit of paint from the pot and then thin it down on our palette with a touch of water. Just a little bit, not too much. There we go. Then, on our dreadnought, here we're going to be painting this all over the top of the base, like so. Now, the reason we're doing this is because later on we're going to be using the crackle paints. They will crack and leave the colour showing underneath. We want a nice Martian colour showing when that happens. Just like that. Alright, up next we'll use Doomball Brown again. We're going to start building up the effect on the bottom of the legs of the Dreadnought to make it look like it's stamping through the dusts of Mars. We'll start with a dry brush of Doomball Brown around the feet and shins of our Dreadnought. And then after that, we'll use Tusk or Fur again to do the same. First of all, the dry brush of Doomball Brown. For this, grab your small dry brush. Take some Doomball Brown from the pot and onto our piece of tissue paper here. Now we're brushing off just about all of the paint onto our tissue paper here. We want a really subtle effect, so we're going to have almost no paint left on the brush. Just like that. Then, onto the dreadnought. Here, we're applying this in a sort of circular dry brush around the feet and legs of the dreadnought. So just like this, you can see it's going on really lightly. Press nice and lightly like this, all around the feet. Now, as for the legs, we'll be going up to about halfway up the shin here, like so. If you're painting a tank or a miniature that's on foot, judge yourself as to how far up, but never really go past the knees of a miniature. We'll do this all around the bottom of the legs, and then we'll move on to the next stage. Next up, a dry brush of Tusk or Fur being placed over the previous dry brush. Here we're pressing a little bit lighter, and also we're not going to go up quite as far as we did, so maybe we'll go up just as far as the bottom of the greaves here. There we go, that's those feet looking pretty cool, but we're going to come back to those later on. Because up next it's time to start preparing the actual Martian base itself. Now before we come to the texture paint, we're going to do something a bit strange. We're going to apply a layer of Ardcoat Gloss Varnish all over the top of the base. You might think, Nick, that's a bit weird, why are you doing that for? Well, the reason is because later on when we use the crackle paints, they'll be able to grip onto the Ardcoat Gloss Varnish a bit more and you'll get bigger cracks as a result. So grab your large base brush and let's do that Ardcoat. Let's take some paint from the pot and onto our palette here. We'll just make sure we're not overloading the brush with too much paint, but don't worry about thinning it down. Straight onto the miniature then. This is a nice even coat of Ardcoat Gloss Varnish all over the top of the base. Now obviously it's going to dry real shiny, but don't worry, by the time this effect is finished, you won't be able to see that shine anymore. So there we go, that's the Ardcoat Gloss Varnish dried. Now it's time to start applying those crackle paints. And the first one we're going to be applying is Martian Iron Earth. For this we're using our extra large base brush. Let's do it. Let's load up our brush, first of all, with plenty of paint here. Make sure it's not overloaded by using the palette here, but just make sure we've got a lot on. That's it, perfect. Then, onto the base of the miniature. Here, we're applying the Martian Iron Earth over the top of the base like so. We're applying it over the entire base, nice and evenly. Now the trick here is you want paint to be about a mil thick so the cracks are perfect. Don't apply it too thick or it will get too big and come off when you try to paint it later on. We're going to paint around the entire base like this. Don't worry if you hit the feet, that's absolutely fine. It'll look quite cool in fact once it's dry. Allow about an hour for it to fully dry properly and get all those cracks coming out. And if you want to speed the process up, you can always use a hairdryer to speed that up. Use it on short bursts of a low heat setting. Otherwise, if you use high heat on long bursts, you might warp the base, and that'd be a nightmare. Wow, that Martian Iron Earth has dried really well, given this awesome cracked effect. But let's add some more texture next by adding some Martian Iron Crust. Here we're going to be adding lots of texture to the base to make it look a bit more rocky and barren and desert-like. Grab your trusty Citadel texture tool for this one, and take some paint from the pot like so. We're going to load up our thick end of the tool here with quite a bit of paint like so, and then onto our miniature. Here, we're applying it in random patches on the model, like so. Now, we've just been patting it down like this and spreading it all over the base. You can do this absolutely to your taste, however you like. Obviously, the more you put on, the more rocky and heavy it will look. Allow again about an hour for it to fully dry. Once it has, we'll move on to the next stage. That's the Martian Iron Crust dry, giving us a really cool variety of textures on the base. Up next, let's shade that base down by using Reichland Flesh Shade. For this, we're using our large shade brush. Let's take some paint from the pot here and onto our palette. Now, we're just making sure we haven't got too much paint on the brush, but we do want to load up quite a bit for this. There we go, then onto our miniature. Here, we're applying a nice even coat of Reichland Flesh Shade all over the entire base. Now, it doesn't matter here if some areas you apply a bit more thickly, it will look nice and natural when it dries. Well, that Reichland Flesh Shade has dried, giving this really cool natural look to the base. Up next, let's apply some dry brushes over the top of that base to highlight it up. First of all, we'll get a dry brush with Jacaro Orange, which we're going to apply to both the base and the feet of the Dreadnought. Then we'll apply Kindle Flame as a second dry brush, this time just on the base. For both of these, we're using our medium dry brush. Let's grab some Jacaro Orange from the pot and onto our piece of tissue paper here. Now, just like before with the dry brushing, we're just brushing off most of the paint onto the piece of tissue paper here, just to make sure there's very little left on the brush. Then, onto our Dreadnought. Here, we're going to be applying this in nice circular motions all over the top of the base, like so. Now, press quite lightly here as you're doing this. Don't press too heavily, or you may end up flaking off some of the basing material, and you don't want to do that. When it gets to the feet of the Dreadnought, simply add a cheeky little light dry brush to the feet as well, just to add a quick highlight and also to blend in with the base. Next up, we're applying a dry brush of Kindle Flame over the top, but this time just on the base. Again, nice circular motions to get a really nice even dry brush. That dry brush done, and the base is looking awesome. There's one last thing we're going to be doing here, which is adding a shade onto the areas of the miniature to make it look like Martian dust has settled in some cracks. For this, we're going to make our own shade using Tusk or Fur and Lamine Medium. Here's how we're going to do it. First of all, with a medium layer brush, take one brush full of Tusk or Fur and apply it to your palette. Then thoroughly wash your brush off. We want to make sure there's no paint left on there at all, as we don't want to contaminate the medium. Bit of tissue paper. But then, with Lamine Medium, we're going to add a few brushfuls here onto the palette. I'm going to maybe add about three brushfuls here and then mix it in like so. And what we've done here is we've created our own Tusk or Fur wash. Perfect. Then using this wash, we're now going to apply this into the recesses on the Dreadnought to make it look like dust has fallen. So here we go. For example, around the rivets on the leg like so, we'll just add a little dot here like that. Maybe a little dot there as well. We'll add a little bit onto the rivets there as well. And also in the cracks in between the armour here as well, like just in here. Now when that dries, it's going to be nice and subtle, but we'll make it look like dust has fallen in the recesses, as it would in real life. Once this has been done, we'll paint the rim of the base with Steel Legion Drab. That wash done, and the rim of the base painted, our Martian base is complete. And that's how you can paint Martian bases and weathering on your miniatures using the Citadel Texture Range. I hope you've enjoyed the video. Happy painting.